need to. More now in the pressure being put on governors to reopen, ready or not, like it or not. Michigan so far has endured the loss of more than 2,500 lives since the outbreak began. It's also seen protesters rally against stay-at-home restrictions, egged on by a presidential call on Twitter in all caps to, quote, liberate Michigan. Michigan's Democratic Governor Gretchen Whitmer responded today on the opinion page of the New York Times, quoting, "Americans everywhere are eager to get back to normal. Trust me, we governors are too, but we need to get this right." Governor Whitmer joins me now. Governor, what is your message to other governors who are already opening up their state economies right now, especially given the guidelines from this White House, which is, you know, has very specific, you know, I mean, as specific as they are, they're not that specific, but it does have guidelines for what needs to be in place. And in the states that are reopening right now, to the extent they are, those things aren't in place.
Right. So the guidelines call for 14 days of seeing numbers start to level off or drop. The guidelines call for, you know, observing best practices, even if we do go back to work, 6 feet away, wearing masks. These are absolutely essential in it. I look to see what other states are doing. All I can tell you is that we in Michigan are taking this very seriously, that we are assessing what is the nature of risk associated with each sector in our economy. How do we scale those? And how do we work with our brightest minds in epidemiology to understand what the inherent risk is? And then what protocols can we take to mitigate that risk? So when it's safe to reengage, that we have a thoughtful, data-driven, rigorous plan to keep the public safe. I think that going too fast will be harder for businesses to have the confidence of the public to come in anyway. If you're not guaranteeing or able to show the thoughtful plan that's gone into people's safety, I think that it's going to be hard to get people to come out and participate anyway. So we got to get this right so we don't have a second wave.
Where is testing in your state now? Where does it need to be in order to have confidence that businesses can reopen? And even things like, you know, handheld thermometers you can point at somebody's forehead, do you have, you know, tens of thousands of those for, you know, or you know, those are hard to find. I've looked in a lot of supermarkets and pharmacies looking for them, and they're hard to get.
Well, where we were with PPE 2 weeks ago when I was imploring for help was we were living day to day. At this juncture, we are, 8 to 21 days. And that's still not a lot, but it's in a much better position than where we are. We know that in order to reengage sectors of our economy, we're going to have to be able to take, you know, these kinds of PPE and ensure that they're available. If you are in any sort of a business where you are front and center, touching clientele, people, the general public, you need to have, you know, PPE to protect yourselves and to protect them as well. And so we've made great strides. Our testing is now we're doing about 6,000 tests a day. We really need to be up to 10,000. I could get to 12,000 tomorrow if I had all the swabs that we need to conduct these tests. So we have the capability. It's the supply chain issue that every state is confronting that is keeping us from doing even more testing so we can feel confident that it's safe to reengage.
So when folks yesterday from the Coronavirus Task Force were saying the president and others, you know, deriding governors for saying, you know, that they need more testing, and the, you know, these folks are saying in the White House, well, there's the capacity is there, you just don't know what you have.
Yeah, so, you know, we had a call with the White House yesterday. All of the governors across the nation, or the vast majority of us, were on it. We engaged. I heard over and over again from my colleagues on both sides of the aisle that this supply chain issue is real for all of us. We have the capacity to process the tests. But if you don't have the swabs and the reagents, you can't do a test. And so if we could get those fundamentals, if the Defense Production Act was utilized and we went to work and started producing these swabs, they're not complicated things to produce. We just need to have a national strategy and the full force and effect of the Defense Production Act to get this done. We need reagents. Those are the two things I know that Michigan's not unique in looking for. And if we could produce it on a, you know, on a number that would supply all of the states, we would all have a lot more confidence that we can safely reengage sectors of our economy.
Well, obviously, you know, the president has talked about liberating Michigan, you know, encouraging people who aren't social distancing while they're protesting his own guidelines He says you're just being too tough on his own guidelines. Just the logic of the protests. I mean, protest is a, you know, is a great thing in this country, but I don't understand the logic behind they're protesting in support of the president, but against his own guidelines. Where do you see these protesters? I mean, now, how do you see this in the grand scheme of what is going on?
Well, let me just explain one thing. You know, Michigan has got the 10th largest population in the country. We have the third highest death rate in the country. We have a unique problem here in Michigan. I know that the story of young Skylar Herbert has been acknowledged on CNN, a five-year-old who lost her battle with COVID-19, two parents who are frontline first responders. This is a unique problem that we are confronting in Michigan, and it calls for a tough solution. I do have some of the most aggressive actions on the books in our nation because I've got one of the worst problems in our nation. I am trying to save lives here. And so while we can respect and revere the right of dissent, the right to demonstrate, right now in this moment, to do so in such an irresponsible way endangers the lives of others. And a momentary sacrifice, which is staying home today, is not just about limiting someone's liberties. It's about ensuring that another person has a right to live, our parents. And so that's why it's so important. And so when I see demonstrations come together where people are not social distancing, they're not wearing masks, they're handing things bare hand to children, passing out candy, I know that when they come from all different parts of our state, congregate, and then go back, that we've got to be very careful and watching. Are we going to see a spread of COVID-19 in parts of the state that maybe didn't have it before? Because that's precisely how it spreads.
I should also point out these protests are actually quite small. I mean, the number of people involved is pretty minuscule compared to the population of your state and in other states. And it doesn't seem to me that they really speak for the vast majority of people out there who are trying to do their best and reflective of the sense that we're all in this together. Governor
right.
Whitmer, I appreciate your time.
I just want to say thank you for making that point. The vast majority of the people in this state and I think across the country are doing the right thing, and we want to thank them. We need to double down right now. We will get through this together.
And it's worth, I mean, the social distancing, the one thing, you know, this is obviously a terrifying situation for everybody. The one thing that gives me personally as a citizen great hope is that science knows what to do. Science tells us social distancing works, and we have seen that. It's just, you know, it's a hard thing to do, and there's obviously a lot of other factors at play, but we know the only thing that works, it's the only tool we really have.
Right, is to just stay away from one another. The virus can't transfer from me to you if we're not together. It's really that simple. It doesn't make isolation easier. It doesn't make the loss of a job easier, the loss of a business. But we do know that we have the power to bring this virus to its knees. But we have to observe these practices. And that's how we save lives. And that's how we shorten the amount of time that we are in this posture. And we can thoughtfully, responsibly think about reengaging sectors of the economy once it's safe to do so.
Yeah. Governor Gretchen Whitmer, I appreciate your time. Thanks.
Thank you.